Hi everybody, are you guys out there? I'm gonna give you a couple of minutes to sign in. Gotta make sure I close up here. I've got the UPS man coming and the dog's gonna bark. So I gotta make sure I take care of all of that. All right, so let me see. Make sure I've got you guys on. This is always the weird part, right? When I have to wait for everybody to log in, make sure we're all there. All right, so like you might have seen in my little preview picture, today I'm going to show you three projects featuring this stamp set, Beetles and Bugs. This is a funny set because I don't remember who it was, but somebody said, ooh, that one gives me the creeps. So if you don't like bugs, I'm sorry. But maybe the projects I show you today will show you that they're not so bad. I mean, I don't love bugs, that's for sure. But it's a fun little stamp set. And I don't know. It was fun playing with it. So I'll show you today three different things. Like usual, I have typed up three project sheets. Hi, Darlene. And these project sheets are gonna, I will post a link to them as soon as the video's over. I'm gonna post all three pictures, and in the description, there will be a link to this page. It has all the products that I used, as well as down here, it'll have the measurements too. So don't worry about any of that while you're watching. You don't need to write it down. You're gonna be able to print it right off as soon as the video is over. As I did last week, we're using the same hostess code, and any orders I get this week between now and next Friday using this hostess code, I'm going to send you a package of these, the Urban Underground Embellishments. We used these last week on our project. Was it last week or the week before? Was it last week spring break? I can't remember. Anyway, the last time we used these on our projects. And those stinking dogs. I don't know if you guys can hear them. I have no idea what they're barking at. Anyway, so any order that is $40 minimum will get a package of these in the mail from me with a thank you card. Also, I'm doing a giveaway again. And I'm actually going to give away this stamp set two of them. Can you guys hear me? Marla, you say no sound? All right, tell me if you guys can hear me. I can hear the dogs for sure barking. Hopefully you can't hear them. Can you guys hear me? There's a little bit of delay, so I'm going to wait and see if I can see if you guys can hear me. Let's shut the door so the dogs hopefully won't be heard. Okay, you have sound. Okay, good. Okay, good, 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 good. I was scared there for a minute. Okay, so I'm giving away two of these this week, two Beetles and Bugs stamp set. I coordinated my blog this time so that I have a post that's posting right now, and it's got the giveaway. It's called a raffle copter, and you enter your name and your email address, and in a week from now, I will have it randomly pick two people, and I will send you each the stamp set. So in order to win, you have to enter the raffle copter and be on my mailing list, okay? Joy, I know. Bugs, I know. It's that time of the year, right? They're coming out in full force. Okay, so yes, I know. I'm sorry, the dogs. I literally in their kennel on the other side of the house. They drive me crazy. Schnauzers, they're known for it. Okay, so I think I covered it all. Hostess code will get you the Urban Underground Embellishments. And if you enter the giveaway that is on my blog right now, I'm going to give away two of these, but you have a week to enter. And I will post that link as soon as I'm done also. Okay, let's get started. The first project I'm going to do is a card. And if I can actually find the card, it's right here. When I first looked at this stamp set, I thought, okay, what can I do? And immediately popped in my head of using all of them at the same time. And then I realized later that there's a card like that in the catalog. So I guess that's why it popped into my head. But it reminds me of when I was in, I think it was maybe sixth grade, we had to do a bug collection and put a pin in the bugs, and that's totally what it reminded me of. But anyway, this is what I came up with. And can you guys hear the dog? He's gonna drive me crazy. There's a man working next door on the house. I guess he can hear him, even though he can't see him. Okay, so anyways, to get started, I'm just gonna get a piece of Whisper White. And I wanna show you how I loaded these guys on my giant block. This is our biggest block. And I put them all on here so that I could just stamp it all at one time. And that way I don't have to worry about getting some one of them crooked or whatever. I can line them all up at the same time, stamp it, see if I like it. And then when it's ready, I can stamp it on my paper. So that's what I'm gonna do. But I did find that I needed a foam mat. This is our piercing mat. I use it for stamping. And sometimes with our photopolymer stamps, you need to use a foam pad underneath. It kind of fills in underneath all that, I don't know, it's like it forms a bubble or something when you don't use a foam mat, but the foam mat kind of smooths it all against the stamps. All right, so I'm just gonna use basic black. Sorry about the shaking. All right, sounds like Charlie is, or maybe that was Mac barking. I have two schnauzers. And why we thought that was a good idea, I'll never know. No, we really do love them very much. We just do not love the barking all day long. All right, there we go. Voila. Now, these are all the bugs in the stamp set. One thing I wanted to point out about the stamp set is that it has the bugs, but then it also has the fill-in color. So like this guy is the outline and this is the fill-in. So I've used all the outline bugs, but I felt like I needed a few more bugs around the edges. So I'm just gonna randomly take these off and put them on my clear block. I mean, you could leave it like that, sure. I mean, I think it would be fine, but I don't know, my perfectionist, I thought, I need more bugs. So I'm just gonna kind of randomly do a few. And kind of, I like them going different directions. Right, there's one. And I don't know what all these weird bugs are. I'm not super scared of bugs, but I mean, I obviously don't love them. But anyway, I don't really know. I mean, I know with the fly and the ant and the rest of them, I think I would just call them all beetles. All right, so let's just randomly fill in a few. I'm going different directions. One cautionary note when you're using your foam mat like this, be careful because the ink here is still a little bit wet. So if you run your hand through it, which hopefully I didn't do, you're gonna smear ink on your hand and then on the paper. I tell you that from experience, unfortunately. Okay, so now I decided I needed one bug to focus on. We were gonna use our little magnifying glass and I chose this guy right here. And I'm gonna use Peekaboo Peach and Daffodil Delight. Let's see, I'm looking at my sample to see what colors I did. So this weird body, little parts of his body, are gonna be Peekaboo Peach. And let's see if I can line this up. All right, and then, yeah, I didn't do a very good job. Oh well, we're going with it. All right, and then, let's see, Daffodil Delight, there we go. All right, so now let's move all the stamps out of the way. We're gonna put this down on basic black. Oh, do I have it too big? I think it's okay. I just have a very small 1/8 inch between these pieces. And so if I cut them wrong, they're not gonna fit. Okay, that's good. Black and Daffodil Delight. All right, now let's make the magnifying glass. You know what I just realized that I did is I popped this up. So instead of stamping him like that, let's do, because I didn't like the way I stamped that anyway. Let's see, we're gonna stamp that weird beetle again. I make these projects sometimes a week in advance, and I actually did make these last week. And then I forget what I did. Okay, so let's see. We're gonna just stamp him. What is up? I'm not stamping very good today. All right, let's try that again. Oh my gosh, I swear my dog never barks this long. Can you guys still hear him? Drives me crazy. We have a rabbit, and they finally all get along beautifully, but occasionally the rabbit will see them and just kind of dart. I don't know if it's like instincts. And then all heck breaks loose. They start chasing her. What? Let's see. Oh my gosh, I am not doing a good job. There, yay, that's good. Okay. But they don't really bark at her. They just, I think it's like the instinctual, they want to chase her. But right now, I don't know what in the world they're barking at. All right, so I'm just going to cut this out around the body. And we're going to put it on with a dimensional. If I can get this. Remember, when you're cutting, always turn the paper, not your scissors. That'll help create a smoother line. I don't have any idea why that is. But I just know that it's true. All right, so let's see. I think we're gonna have to cut our dimensional in half. Put it on here. And now it's popped up a little bit. All right, see? Ooh, it's a little creepier like that, but I like it. Okay, so let's do the sentiment. The sentiment, I wanted to find something to go with this, and I kind of looked through the catalog. I love to pull out sentiments from other sets and use them for different meanings. And so I kind of, I played around with a few things, and then I thought, hello there. I thought that was cute. So this is the, one of our kits. It's called Oh Happy Day Card Kit. You guys, do you recognize this? It's the one that's in the very front of the catalog, and it includes a stamp set. So that's the stamps that I'm using. But I challenge you to look through the catalog, look through your sentiments, and see what you have and kind of get creative with it. Sometimes you can piece words together to make different sayings. I really like doing that. You can use post-it notes. Let me think. What do I need to do? Okay, it doesn't matter. I have plenty of room. Oh, good grief. That dog. He's going to be in big trouble when I'm done. Hello there. That's what he's saying to the workman next door. Hello there. I want to bite you. The funny thing is he's our wimpy dog. He's scared of everything. Okay, so guys, my camera is mounted to the table. So when I use my big shot, the table shakes a little bit. I'm thinking I need to just go over there and do something about him, but I hate leaving you guys just hanging here. So let's see. I'm going to cut this out, and then I am going to go take care of him if he's still barking like he's barking. All right, so now I'm going to take some silver foil. At the same time, I need to make the ring for the magnifying glass right here. So I'm going to put this here and this here, like this. These, the measurements will be on the project sheet. I'm going to create a ring, so we put one smaller one in, one big one. Okay, guys, pause. I'm going to go take care of the dog. I'll be back. They're outside now. They're the neighbor's problems. Okay, let's cut this out. Sorry, you guys. You can never predict what's gonna happen on a Facebook Live. You never know. Okay, so let's take this ring out, and I'm actually going to cut two of these rings. I know I'm out of the camera, but I'm doing the exact same thing. I'm pulled over here so you can see it. I wonder what the funniest thing that's ever happened to somebody on Facebook Live. I don't know. If you guys saw that recent video of that dad that was being interviewed by, I don't know, I think it was BBC, and the kids came in, and the mom comes flying in. I laughed so hard over that. I couldn't stop watching it because I feel like that is my life. Every time I try to make a video, something happens. Okay, this is a window sheet. You guys know window sheet, and it's actually a scrap. That's why it's in a weird shape. Window sheet. No, Marla, it's not tin foil. It's silver foil. It's in the catalog. It comes in a pack of two, and it's $4. It's called silver foil. All right, so I cut out the larger circle of that window sheet, okay? The larger circle, not the smaller one. And one other thing I'm gonna do for the handle, do you guys recognize that? That's the tie from the t-shirt set that I used a few weeks ago. And I was actually, like I told you, I did these last week, and this week, I was just looking on Pinterest and I saw somebody made a magnifying glass using the handle from the hammer. So your handle for your magnifying glass could be potentially lots of things. All right, now normally I would say use your liquid adhesive to put this together, but liquid adhesive is touchy and hard to, it takes a while to dry. So I'm just taking glue dots and putting this together. Like that, and let's put the little tie slash handle like that, and then you have a magnifying glass. Okay, now I needed it to be a little bit higher because we put a dimensional on here. So I'm actually using these foam adhesive strips, and these were designed for to make shaker cards, but you know what, they're also just like dimensionals, but they're a little bit taller than a regular dimensional. So I'm going to put that on the back like that. And you know, you could make this a shaker, couldn't you? That'd be a fun shaker. We're going to do a shaker in a minute. If I can ever get this project done, I feel like I've been working on this project for an hour now. Okay, so peel all that off. And let's put it on this bug right here, just like that. Oh, I love it, so cute. All right, now we're gonna do this. You know what, let's see, can I move this up a little bit? Because we need to make room for that. There we go. Okay, I'm almost done. We're gonna use, this is the Crush Curry striped twine, and I'm gonna use two pieces and tie it like I have one piece in my hand. That's all you gotta do when you're making these double bows. Let's make it a little bit smaller. Trim off those tails. And the last embellishment are the little paper clips, the mini paper clips that are in the Occasions catalog. I really like those. I wish they would carry over to the new catalog because I'll be sad to see them go. All right, a dimensional on the back. We'll make it look like it's hooked on there. And then a glue dot. Right here for the bow. We're gonna fake it. We didn't really tie it on there. That's too tedious. We're just gonna attach it. All right, yay, first project done. It only took me forever, yay. Okay, so cute. And this, I didn't point this framelit out. This is actually from the popcorn box thinlet collection. If you don't have it, just use whatever you have to, you know, you could even do an oval there, it would be cute. Okay, let me move that out of the way. I hope you guys like that. I am going to make some room for the next project. The next one is a fast and easy one. And I'm going to actually use one of my favorite products, the Curvy Keepsake Box. I love it. Do you guys have the Curvy Keepsake Box? It is really easy to put together. It doesn't hold too much, so you don't spend a fortune on candy, which I always like. And it is just really, I mean, I'm sure you've seen a million things, a million ways to use it. So I was inspired by the ant. Here's the little ant. And I thought picnic, gingham, a little summer themed treat box. So that's what I came up with. And let me show you how I did it. So in case you don't have the Curvy Keepsake framelit, it looks like this. It's kind of weird looking. And you need two of them, two out of Whisper White. And I'm using this stamp set. I've used this with you guys on a live video before also. It's called Thoughtful Banners. And this is my go-to when I don't really know what sentiment I want to use or what it should say. I didn't really have anything. I couldn't come up with anything for this. And then I thought, well, sweet and fun. That could be anything, right? So that's what I used here. Okay, so let's make the gingham. That is this weird bar right here. I use that stamp, I think, more than any other stamp in the set. Let me get my grid paper because this is kind of messy. We're going to do the side with a loop on it, okay? That's the side we're putting the gingham on. And we're going to use this bar and some real red. And I'm just going to start kind of up here at the top like that. And I'm just going to start stamping. Hopefully I can get it somewhat straight. It you know what? It looks like a bowling pin to me at this point. I thought that when I first made it, kind of, if you just put those two little stripes at the top, it looks like a bowling pin. All right, and then we're going to turn it. And we're going to go this way. Nothing says summer picnic to me more than a red gingham blanket or, you know, paper plates. Now, it doesn't go all the way. It's not tall enough, but that's okay. We'll just extend the stamp like that. I love gingham. I don't know if it's out of style. I don't think it is because I see it all the time. Okay, before I stamp this, I need to make sure that I have the right side because when we put these together, they're going to be, they need to be opposites. So it'll be like this. Okay, so make sure you look at it before you stamp it. So I need to stamp, yep, this side right here. All right. But anyway, I love gingham. I have always loved gingham. My mom uses gingham a lot, so maybe that's why I like it. It just reminds me of home. Looks like there's a little fuzz that's tracking ink down my project. I don't know if you guys can see that. Little, probably a blonde hair flying around connected to the stamp. All right, a couple of more, and we'll put it together. All right. Now, red ink, go over there and don't get on anything, please. Let's move that. All right, so we want those to be on the outside. So we're gonna turn them over like this. And you wanna adhere the two that are the same across from each other. Uh-oh, are you guys still there? Oh yeah, okay. My feed froze for a second. I have you guys on the iPad trying to see what you guys are saying. Occasionally I remember to look up. All right, so I just used Fast Fuse and we're just gonna kind of fold those in like this. So you can see how the red ink kind of, it's very messy. If I can make it through this project without smearing red ink on here, it'll be great. I like to take my bone folder and curl these in a little bit to give it more of that bubble look. You know, if it's filled with treats, it's easier to kind of make it look full, but if I don't do this, it kind of looks meh. I don't know, not so hot. All right, so now we need the ant. So let me go remove him from our big block from earlier. And I'm just going to have him, let's see, going up and across. You kind of have to think about, I mean, I guess truly it doesn't matter on a project like this because the ants would be all over it probably if there was candy inside. Let's have them go down. And maybe one random one over here. All right, so now when you put this together, you pinch the little handles and you fold this over and you fold that over. And there it is. All right, so let's make the little sentiment. I already cut out. This is one of the framelits that comes with a curvy keepsake. It's just a little tag. And then I'm gonna use some Whisper White. And I have these stamps from the Thoughtful Banners already ready. It's Fun and Sweet, or Sweet and Fun. Okay, and real red, and then the little and in basic black. And I'm gonna punch it out with a 3/4 inch circle punch. And we're gonna put it on there. I think you could make a lot of these if you needed to, if you were having a summer picnic or, you know, pool party or something. These would be fast and easy. All right, wait, now we gotta add the ant onto the tag too. That. There we go. All right. Now, when you put something on the curvy keepsake box, you need to think about how the person's going to open it. So look at, this is the one that they have to open first. If we were to put that tag on top of here, then when we pulled this off, it would pop it off. So you want to make sure that you stick it to the side that's going to open first. All right. So I'm going to use a dimensional. I know, shocker, right? And I'm going to put that right here on this side. And then I'm going to real quickly make a real red satin ribbon bow. Like that. All right. Now, let's do a little blue dot. Just like that. And there they are. So cute, fun, perfect for your upcoming summer or spring picnics. All right, I hope you guys like that project. I think it's cute, if I do say so myself. All right, let me get a bunch of this junk out of here and we'll move on to the third project. Thank you guys, I appreciate it. All right, where is my other box? Here we go. You know, I need to close this real red. I don't know about, I just stuck my thumb in it. I don't know about you guys, but real red is like, it's just, it gets everywhere. I have black yoga pants on, and I told you guys before what I do to my black yoga pants. If you could only see the ink stains on them, it would not be good. Okay, I think I've got everything out of the way. There's my thumb. Hopefully I'm not going to get that on our next project. Okay, so the next one, I have to tell you, I like to come up with three projects. This one was just eluding me. I could not really decide. I knew I wanted to make another 3D, but what would we put in here? I looked for some bug candy, didn't really find anything that I liked. So can you guys guess what is in here? I don't know. What do you think it is? I was thinking this would be, and it says you'll thank me later. I was thinking it would be funny to give to friends at an outdoor party, or I always think of my kids' teachers at recess. I used to teach recess, so I know we at this time of the year we get those little. Forgot to turn my phone on silent. Somebody was calling. Anyways, we get those little no-see-em gnats. This would be great for recess. A little bug spray. I know, it's so cute. I found it at CVS, our pharmacy, but then I also saw them at Target. Okay, so and you can see that this is a shaker box. All right, let's make the box. You're gonna need a piece of Peekaboo Peach that is 5 by 7 3/4. And remember, this will be on the project sheet after the video is over, so don't worry. 5 by 7 3/4, and we're gonna score the long side at 1/2 inch, 1.5, 6 1/4, and 7 1/4. And the short side, we're gonna score at 1/2 inch, 1.5, 2 3/4, and 3 3/4. Okay, now before we do any cutting, we're gonna do some stamping. So let me get my little bugs. He's still over there. Is this the one that I used? Yeah, the little bugs off of my big block. We're going to do Peekaboo Peach. And just random all over, like he's crawling. There's nothing worse than a bug crawling on you in the spring, and you're slapping at him, and ugh. We're supposed to have a really bad mosquito season. I'm not excited. We'll see. Who knows? All right. One there. Okay. Now, I'm going to cut a window out of here. And this is a framelit. Somebody on my Facebook group, I think, suggested this. It is from, they're called the Project Life. Let me look it up so I get it right. The Project Life Cards and Labels Framelit. So I made something recently, for my Easter class, and she suggested, instead of the way that I did it, that to use this one to create the window, and I thought it was a really good idea. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to put it on, we have a section that's a little bit bigger then this section, and then a little bit bigger, and then this section. So we're just gonna put it on that middle, little bit bigger section, okay? And we're gonna run it through. Gotta make sure you center it really well. Sorry about the shaky table. Sorry. All right, now, it was not big enough, so I'm just gonna put it, make sure it pops in where it matches the sides here, and I'm gonna slide it down a little bit to make it a little bit bigger. Now, if you don't have this framelit, just cut a window from it. You can take like a scrap piece of paper that would be about, probably about an inch by 3.5 inches, and trace it, and then cut it out using your paper trimmer. Okay, so now we've got to do some trimming. First thing we're going to do is cut these tabs off right here. I'm looking at my sample. I hope I have this right. I hope I remember it. Then I'm going to cut up here and cut these off. All right, now back over here. Cut those and those. So basically, we're just leaving the tabs at the end of where we cut our window. All right, so now we need to make what's gonna go behind our window. And this is a piece of Whisper White, 1 3/4. No, let's see, let me look at my measurements. It looks like I left it off the measurements. I believe it's 1 by 4. All right, so let's go back and stamp our bug. I'm gonna do a couple of bugs on here, a couple of different bugs, because I want it to look like there's bugs crawling around in the box. I know, it's so creepy. Some of you are like, I cannot even watch this. I don't like bugs. But this is cute, little stamps. Somebody in your life would like it, I promise. Okay, let's see. What other bug did I use? One of the beetles. They're all beetles. All right, let's do this. That one, and that one. All right, and then we've got to fill them in. So you got to come over and look at your stamp set, and it they're labeled. It'll tell you, you can look at them. So this guy is right here, and that's the one that goes in it, and it looks like I already pulled it out. Oh yeah, I did. Look, I was working ahead. Anyway, they're numbered, so you can kind of see which one goes with which. All right, I was supposed to do this in Watermelon Wonder, but I don't see it, so we'll do Peekaboo Peach. Peekaboo Peach and Watermelon Wonder are my current faves. I'm sure you guys have noticed that I can't stop using them. I apologize. No, I don't apologize. I love those colors. And Watermelon Wonder is getting ready to go bye-bye. Oh, look, there it is. I found it. It's getting ready to retire. So if you like it, stock up on the ink, the refill, the cardstock, because once it comes, it's gone. I mean, once it retires, it's gone, and there's nothing we can do about it. Okay, now we're ready to put our shaker together. Now on the back, I'm gonna take some glue dots, and again, I'm using glue dots because liquid glue and I struggle, and I don't want you guys to laugh at me when I'm trying to use liquid glue on a window sheet. So we're gonna pretend like that's liquid glue, okay? We're just using some glue dots. Here's our window sheet. And let's put it down. Now we're gonna go back with those. There's those foam adhesive strips again. And we don't want them to show through the window, so make sure that you get them in the right, on the right side. You know, you wanna make sure they're outside of that window. And we're gonna just go around the edges. We're gonna use some of the sprinkles embellishments. It's funny, my dog's not barking anymore now. He knows that he got banished outside and he's probably all sad. That's what happens when you bark nonstop and mommy's trying to do Facebook Live. Okay. There we go. Now, sprinkles embellishments are right here. Let's sprinkle, ha ha ha, pun intended, a few of those in there. And be careful not to do what I did and get them stuck on the side. Like that. And then we're going to get this piece that we decorated a minute ago. And we're going to lay it. Come on. Right on top of there. And there, now we have a shaker box. It's like a hidden window in there. You see that? All right, so now the box goes together pretty easily. I'm using Fast Fuse, and we're gonna put Fast Fuse here on that edge. Like that, and we're gonna put Fast Fuse also on the bottom here. Oh, let's see, I guess it doesn't matter because the bugs are crawling all different directions. So whichever side you decide to make the bottom. Stick that in there. Come on. There we go. Oh my goodness. All right, so anyways, we'll pretend like it's sticking. And put this one in there. Now let's make the tag. I, again, was like, okay, sentiment. What sentiment could I use for this? What would work with this? So I looked and looked and looked and had several things I thought would work. But then I saw this one. You'll thank me later. I thought that was funny for bug spray. Yeah, you think you don't need bug spray. You'll thank me later now that you have this tiny little bug spray in your purse. All right, so I'm going to stamp it in basic black on Whisper White. Oops, I'm going to need that again. And we're going to do our bug again. If I can find it. If it was a bug, it would have bit me. Ahaha, just kidding. Okay, here it is. I'm going to stamp him like that and fill him in with the other little, the filler stamp. There we go. All right, let's move everything out of our way. Make room for the big shot. We're going to cut it out with the stitched shape circle. Do you guys have the stitched shaped framelits? I cannot stop using them. I mean, I pretty much have abandoned everything else and only seem to be able to use these on every project. They're my favorite. All right, see how it has the stitching? We need more sizes and more shapes with stitching. Stamping up, I hope you're listening. All right, now I use the scallop circle from the layering circle framelits. And I'm just gonna put that there. And then I'm just going to put it kind of across the window like that with some dimensionals. There we go. Now, he's a little wonky. I need to fix him at the bottom. Now we're going to take some pool party ribbon and tie it around because no project is complete in my world without a ribbon. Or a bow, I should say. Not necessarily a ribbon. It can be any kind of bow. And that way, they just slide that off and it'll open up. Ugh, there we go. All right, there he is. Cute, right? A little shaker box. And if you didn't see earlier, it's a tiny little bug spray that I got at CVS. But they have them everywhere. Okay, so let's review. Where's my card? Here we had this, we had the bug spray, and we had the card right here. Now, look, those bugs aren't so scary. They're cute, right? They're super cute. All right, so you guys, I hope you like these projects. I'm gonna post the product sheets in just a minute. On my Facebook group page, there'll be a link. Thank you, Twyla. I know, it's cute, right? Bugs aren't scary. If you want to put an order in the next week, use this hostess code and I will send you a pack of the Urban Underground embellishments in your thank you card. And hop over to my blog right now. There's a giveaway. I'm giving away two of these cute bug stamps. And two people will win them next week. And I promise this time I won't forget to let you guys know. This week, I promise, I contacted the person who won. I arranged it, put it in the mail, and then I forgot to tell everybody else who won. But anyways, I promise. I'll let you guys know this time if who the winners are. All right. I think that's it. I think I better go rescue my dogs from, you know, being outside since they're such wimps. Thanks, guys, for joining me. See you next time. Bye.